you have not stopped sending us your COVID-19 questions, so we are not going to stop answering them. Tonight, we have two doctors joining us, Dr. Taslim Nimji, an ER physician, and Dr. Isaac Bogosh, an infectious diseases specialist. Hello to the two of you. Let's get right to the questions because we've got more than a few of them to answer. This one's for you, Dr. Nimji. With the warmer weather, can I get together with friends if we all stay 2 meters apart?
Gonna go with a no. This is not in the spirit of what we're trying to do. Stay home, don't hang out with your friends.
Simple as that. Okay, Dr. Bogosh, next one's for you. Speaking of the warmer weather, of course, can mosquitoes spread the virus? That's an interesting one.
Yeah, that's a great question. And you know, certainly we're gonna see more and more mosquitoes in the warmer months ahead. We have to remember that this is a respiratory virus. There are many other respiratory viruses like influenza and RSV and parainfluenza, and the list goes on and on and on. None of these other respiratory viruses, including the coronaviruses that we know of, are transmitted through mosquitoes. So I think it would be extremely unlikely that this one is.
Okay, good to know. Dr. Nimji, this next question I've had, particularly in a hospital setting, so maybe you can answer. Can you reuse a paper or N95 mask if you disinfect it somehow, like put it in the microwave?
So certainly not if you put it in the microwave. I wouldn't try that experiment at home. We are looking at all kinds of methods that we could employ really for preservation of our PPE supplies. And hospitals are looking at how they might reprocess these masks using evidence-based methods to do so, to ensure that if we're reusing them, we're doing so safely. So this isn't something you'd want to try to do at home.
But and what are the methods? I mean, do you steam them or what do you do?
So we're looking at processing with UV light, for example, as one of the things being done. And there's sort of a technical and complicated process to do so. And really, we're really in the early stages, and this would be a last resort for us.
Okay, next question, Dr. Bogosh, for you. We keep hearing about infection through the eyes, nose, and mouth. What about ears?
Oh, that's a great question as well. You know, certainly the ears are a mucous membrane, and, you know, certainly it could theoretically be possible. I think if we're going to make a list of the order of probability of which mucous membrane this is going to come in on the head, let's keep it there, the ears would be last. But I guess it's possible. It is a mucous membrane.
Okay, interesting. Dr. Nimji, does it help to hold my breath when I have to pass someone within 2 meters?
So, I mean, really no one's been able to do studies and tests on this, but ideally, I think what's most important is that you're keeping your 2 meter distance. And if you are, you don't need to hold your breath. You can breathe. Just keep your distance.
Okay. Dr. Bogosh, we've got time for one more quick question. It seems age and medical history determine how seriously you get sick. But is there more to explaining why some people get so sick and others not at all?
Yes, there certainly is more than meets the eye here, because sadly we've seen, you know, some young people, luckily it's not common, but some young people get sick, and certainly not all elderly people get sick. Some people take a tough path and other people recover. So there are likely other genetic factors that are playing a role here, and there's likely basically a dance between the virus and someone's immune system and how they interact together that will really determine which path someone goes down.
Right. Really fascinating answers tonight, as every night. Dr. Bogosh, Dr. Nimji, thanks so much.
Thank you.